Greetings, Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 friends, and welcome to Patriot 6. This tutorial is part of a series of single subject videos designed for quick reference to supplement my long form tutorials. If you're new to using SDK or need a refresher on the tools, I recommend a tutorial on getting started and learning the tools. This tutorial will give you all the basics from obtaining SDK and setting up scenery folders to operating the developer camera and building polygons. You can find a link to this tutorial in the description below. Please click on the Show More button and the tutorial will be the first YouTube link you see. And now on to the quick reference guide. In this quick reference guide, I'm going to start a fictional airport package. The first step is to find a suitable location for a fictional airfield. Most likely you have a location already in mind, but for me I had to select a place. Select a site for the fictional airfield. And I've selected this ground here. It's in Western Kentucky, and when I was a young man, this used to be a farm airfield. So I'm going to use this as my fictional airfield. Obtain the airfield coordinates. And I'm simply in Bing Maps. So I'm going to right-click in the center of this location and go down to the option that says copy, and I'm going to copy the GPS coordinates. And here is a text editor, and in this text editor, I'm going to paste these coordinates. And it is vital that we use the correct coordinates for the airfield package. Obtain the airfield location elevation in meters above mean sea level. The next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to find the elevation at this location. And here is a website that I have found, and I will link this website below. And this website allows you to pop in GPS coordinates and get the elevation in meters. And we do need it in meters for MSFS 2020. So I'm going to paste the coordinates in and calculate. And the result is 115.2 meters. And I'm going to place the elevation 115 meters into the text editor. Developer's mode. Now that we have a location selected, let's go into developer's mode by going to Options, General Options, Developers, On, Apply and Save. Zone into the location. Now let's go back to the world map. And let's copy the GPS coordinates again from the text editor. And let's paste the GPS coordinates in the search bar. And now I'm going to start over here, but we'll be working in this area here. I'm going to make sure the live weather is off and the time of day is roughly around noon. Steps before opening editors. And now in the area, I'm going up to the developer menu. I'm going to options, and I'm going to pause the simulation. And now I'm going to select ready to fly. Now I'm going up to the developer menu. I'm going to select camera and grab the developer camera. Open the scenery editor. And now I'm at the location. So the next step is to open up the scenery editor. So on the developer menu, I'm going to editors, and I'm going to project editor. And the first thing I'm going to do on the project editor is go to view and bring up the inspector. Build the scenery folder. In the next step on the project editor, I'm going to project and select new project. So the first step is to go up to the project folder and select the folder where you want the airport to be saved. I want it to be saved in the working scenery folder. I'm going to select that folder. I'm going to use the ICAO code I plan to use for this fictional airport as the name, P6KY. And now I'm going to create the project. I'm going to select package and hit next. I'm going to select airport. I'm going to enter the same name, P6KY. I'm going to tick next. And now the option comes up to override an existing airport or create an airport anywhere. I'm going to use create airport anywhere. I'm going to type in P6KY. And now I'm going to give it a name. Now we want to go ahead and enter our lat and long because it has to be accurate. If we don't get the accurate lat and long, the airfield will not show up in this location on the map. And I'm going to copy the latitude first. And now I'm going to grab the longitude. And copy that in. And now we want the altitude. And the altitude is also on the text editor. 115 meters. So I enter 115 meters in altitude. So now we've selected create an airport anywhere. I have entered an ICAO. I've given the airfield a name. I've entered the correct latitude and longitude and the correct altitude. And now I'm going down and create the airport. And you'll notice information is now up in the inspector, along with the package name down in the project editor. Add your own thumbnail. And now I'm going to add a thumbnail. So I'm going to tick on the thumbnail placeholder and grab the thumbnail I have created and add it. Important, create the initial package. And this next step is vital. If you do not build the initial package, nothing will work and you will be stuck. So at this point, I'm going to build the initial package. On the inspector, down here on the bottom, build package. And this dialog box always pops up. It's safe. It's just letting you know the information has changed. Tick yes. And the package is now built. And on the console, you will see errors at the top. and there are 144 potential errors, but I have contributed zero, and that's a good thing. Now I'm going to exit out of the console, confirm the initial package is complete and in the specified folder. The package is already built, and if we pull up the working scenery folder, we can see P6KY folder in here with information in it, including the package. So we have a good start here. Close the tools. I'm going to close down the tools, material editor, and the project editor. Wrap up and additional information. And I will stop right there. And these quick references will continue to come out until we get all the way through it. If you're not a subscriber of Patriot 6, please consider subscribing. So when the next quick start guide comes out, you will be notified. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, you can leave those below. There are limitations to what we can fix over YouTube chat. There's other alternative ways you can reach me, and you can find that in the description below. And I want to thank you for watching this quick reference guide in this Patriot 6, and I will see you very soon.